Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to install the version 3 PCV Fix Kit from CruzeKits.com. The first thing you're going to need to do is to remove the evap purge valve and the corrugated PCV line that comes off the intake manifold and goes to the turbo. For the evap purge valve, which is this thing right here, you basically squeeze these two clips from the side and these two fasteners loosen that way and you can take it right off. There's a harness that's going to plug into here and a fuel line into there with a quick disconnector also. There's a little rubber piece that holds it on here, and when you've got your intake manifold on the car, it's going to look something like this. It's going to come in through here, through this little slit, and it's going to pop on right here. So, just to let you know where to find this. The next thing you're going to need to remove is this corrugated line. And this goes from the intake manifold to the turbo and connects right on top over here. Now, I do want to warn you when you take this off, there's a little plastic ring in there. Trying to see if I can show it to you with this camera. And there's a plastic ring on top and an O-ring underneath. This plastic ring tends to fall off when you're removing it, and if you lose it, then you're kind of screwed because it's not going to seat right and it's going to cause a boost leak. Also, the other end of the terminal on the turbo side might leak a little bit. What I would recommend doing is just clean it up with some, you know, some brake clean after you take it off, just to make sure you don't have any issues down the road with this one. These don't really fail all that often, so I'm not too concerned about that one. But this line, the actual hose, tends to crack very easily. I like to joke about it that it's made of peanut brittle, because even if you look at it, it tends to crack. So anyways, the cool thing about this version 3 PCV Fix Kit is not just that it addresses the missing intake manifold check valve, but also that it replaces that hose. And at the time of writing, that hose is like $45 from GM. It used to be like $36, and for some reason the price went up. In any case, what you're going to need to start out with is some tools. So you'll need a vise. That's preferred. You don't absolutely need it, and I'll explain more in the video, but you'll need the vise, you'll need a heat gun, you'll need some brake and parts cleaner, some silicone spray, a Phillips screwdriver, a brush. You can use nylon or brass brush or just an old toothbrush, really, and then some kind of a cutter, like scissors. I like to use this one right here, or you can use even a knife. And I'll show you what those are going to be used for soon in the video. So the first thing we're going to address is the missing intake manifold check valve. And this is one of the biggest failures on these cars. If you've watched one of my other videos, you'll see what I'm talking about. So inside this intake manifold, down this path right there, there's normally a check valve from the factory. The problem is that check valve tends to either crack or disappear or clog or leak or get gummed up with deposits or whatever, and it basically is unreliable even if it's actually there. We've had people, you know, leak test these things and spray some soapy water inside, and they see bubbles coming out because that thing is leaking even if the check valve's there. So I generally recommend that the kit be installed anyway, just because it's more reliable, it's serviceable, and you're not gonna, it prevents problems down the road. Easiest way for me to show you how to do this is here in my shop. Now, normally you can install this in your engine bay, so you don't have to remove the intake manifold to do this. But for the purpose of this instruction video, it's much easier for me to show you what's going on if I do it here. Plus, it's like 22 degrees outside, so this epoxy is going to take forever to harden in that temperature. So the easiest way for me to do this, I keep saying that, is I cut up an intake manifold in half. And you'll see what I'm talking about with the old intake manifold check valve right over there. It's hard to see with this camera, but you'll notice over here some holes. And these holes right here, there's a hole in the middle and some holes on the outside. This is where the old check valve used to be. In the back, it looks kind of like that. I apologize for the lighting, but that's kind of what it looks like. So the first goal is to basically plug that up. And previously, you'd have to, you know, run a screwdriver down inside, you know, a longer one than this one, obviously, with a screw and a washer. But I figured out a better way to do it, which is a lot simpler, and you can do it from the top of the manifold. And so what we're doing here is the kit includes, oh, let me show you what the kit's supposed to include, just to make sure before you start, you've got everything you need. So you're going to need the epoxy, which I already started on because it takes like 15 minutes to set. And after that, you don't have much time. This is actually starting to set pretty good now, so we'll be moving soon. You're going to get four hoses of 5/16 and three 5/8 hoses, a hose retainer, a screw, a little nylon washer, a 90 degree elbow, six of these bigger hose clamps, five of these smaller hose clamps, and one of these T-fittings, which I actually had a custom mold made for. I ordered a bunch of those, a Y-fitting, and a check valve. Oh, and also you'll get some butyl rubber, and I'll show you what this is for in just a second, and this clip. This is what we're plugging the old check valve with. It's going to have a flat edge on the top. All right, now I highly recommend you use these. The only thing is, when you're installing it, make sure that you rotate it so that the edges don't rub against something and, you know, start cutting into something. But these are nice because they're OEM style, decrement coated, and they are constant tension clamps. So with the heat increase and decrease, the constant heat cycles in your engine bay, these always provide tension. Whereas worm drive clamps, which I know some people like to replace these with, don't do that. They don't adjust based on expansion and contraction. So they tend to loosen over time or be tight sometimes and not other times. Okay, so the way that we plug the old check valve, and again, I expect this to be done in your engine bay, not having to remove the intake manifold, because that's half the point, is first you're going to have to clean this. So again, I recommend use some brake parts cleaner. I like the Amsoil stuff because it really doesn't leave any residue and it works really quickly and dries. You're going to want to spray it inside that port, then use the brush. Basically just stick the brush down in through there. And just kind of, you'll see what it's doing over here. Kind of move it left and right a bunch, up and down a little bit, just to make sure you scrub that whole area really, really well, okay? And I'm just showing you what it's doing, but you can do this without seeing everything, but it's easier for you to understand what's happening if you see the side, okay? After that, I recommend you blow it out with some air, look down there with a screwdriver, and make sure that this right here is flat, it's not oily, that it's, you know, like a matte finish, and it's dry. You don't want it to be wet when you start, okay? The next thing we're going to want to do is get a thin screwdriver. Now, to give you an impression how thin this is my Phillips and this is my flathead. You're going to want a thin flathead, okay? And to make sure that your flathead's long enough, just kind of stick it down the port and make sure that it stops before, you know, it bottoms out in the handle, which this is just fine. Most screwdrivers for this purpose are going to be just fine. You're going to want to clean this with some parts cleaner as well, just to let you know. So, grab some of this butyl rubber. I'm going to angle the camera down a little bit here. Grab some of this butyl rubber. You don't need much, really just a little. And basically, dab it on the end of this screwdriver, like that. And stick this clip onto it with the flat edge facing down. Now you're going to want to make sure the clip is at about the same height as the screwdriver, which in this case is right about there. And again, once you got this on, you can pretty much hold the clip up from the screwdriver as long as you don't, you know, angle it left and right or up and down too hard. So it's pretty strong. So this gives you some confidence, but I would still recommend you get a steady hand for this. Next, we're going to put some epoxy on there. Again, this has had plenty of chances to set. This is probably a little bit too thick at this point, but it should be fine for the video. And we're going to want to put some on top of the clip here. This stuff is kind of a mess to work with. I really don't recommend you get any on your hands or on the screwdriver because it's a bit of a pain to clean off afterward. And that should just about do it. All right. So you've got this much epoxy. Make sure you've got the tip of it exposed so you can see what you're doing. Kind of make sure the clip is flat on the edge right there. And the next thing we're going to do, and I'm going to show you again, is you're going to want to lower it down through the check valve port. Make sure to keep this edge along the wall. Lower down through the check valve port until it gets down to the bottom. And once it gets down to the bottom, you're going to want to kind of feel around and make sure you can get to the center hole, which is right around there. And once you get to the center hole, just snap the thing right in, okay? Just kind of give it some angle with a screwdriver, push it in, and you're pretty much done. Whatever's left behind is fine. Now you can see from this other end, it pushes through some of that epoxy. So it seals up all the holes to the clip, and the whole clip is sealed around from the outside. So once this actually cures, it's not going anywhere. Now again, you're not going to be able to see the side of the intake manifold when you're doing this, but as you can see, it's pretty easy. Now I had a bit of a harder time trying to align it left and right, because I'm looking at it at this angle, so it's kind of hard to see it. But when you're going at it and you're looking down, you know, you can kind of see what you're doing. You can even shine a flashlight in there, just kind of ride the edge down until you get to the bottom and just kind of like push it in nice until you find it. Because once you find the hole, it'll go in pretty easily. Okay, and this clip is pretty much not going anywhere. This is permanent. Okay, so we're just going to assume that we already did this on this other manifold. And this is how you install the rest of the kit. So remember how I told you that you needed evap purge line. This is the second step in the process. And what you're going to want to do with this one is basically cut it. I think it was like 2¼ inches down. And you're going to want to install this this Y fitting right around like there. So kind of mark it where you're going to cut it. Kind of hold it up to it like that. And to where, you know, it kind of like, to where the line kind of goes straight down that way and straight down that way. And get the knife and mark it where the end of the hose would go. So in this case, it's right around there. And in this case, it's right around there. And I think the distance is about 5/16, but I don't remember exactly. So we've got two cuts to make right there. So I'm going to take our cutters, cut that piece off. I'm going to take these cutters, cut this piece off right there. Okay? All right. So we end up with two pieces right here. And the next part, some people have a little bit of trouble with, but I'm going to show you the easiest way to do it. You're going to want some silicone spray. Again, if you want the AMSOIL stuff, just let me know. I can get it for you in a package with an oil changer or whatever. This is where you're going to need your vise. Going to grab your Y fitting. The vise is really handy. I don't recommend doing it with somebody else holding it because they're just going to get burned. Grab the vise and clamp it in the center. Don't clamp it too hard. It's just plastic. You don't need to clamp it very hard. And, again, you're clamping on this end and that end. That end you're leaving free. Okay. Actually, forgot one thing. Get some silicone spray on this, on all edges. Okay, because it'll make your job a lot easier if you have that. Alright. Gonna get your heat gun. I like to use this one. I got this one off Amazon. It was pretty cheap. But most of you should have one. And this side is where the check valve side of the evap purge valve is going to go. So get your heat gun and kind of heat this up. Really, you don't need to heat it up for much. If you go too long, you're going to melt it. Just kind of start pushing it down as you're heating it up. Kind of wiggle it. Get all sides hot. And once you get it in there, you should be able to just push it down. If you can't, it's not warm enough. You see, I'm rotating it as I'm heating it up because you want it to be even all the way through. There, just kind of wiggle it and just push it down. Again, the vise really helps because it just kind of keeps it secure. And you'll notice this went almost all the way through. That's good enough. All right. You can kind of twist a little bit, but once this dries up, it's going to seal really well. Then you just repeat for the other side. Just clamp this down. And we're going to do the same thing again. Spray with some silicone spray. Sorry. All right. The last one I probably didn't heat up enough. I like to go a little less than too much because if you do too much, you melt it. There it goes. So it's pretty easy to work with as long as you don't melt the line. So it goes in pretty nicely. Okay. All right. So we're done with that part. The next part is going to be this corrugated line. So you got to get the terminals off of this thing right here. And you can use a knife, you can use whatever. If you use a knife, just be careful, don't cut yourself. But if you just kind of hold it in and just kind of wiggle it through, you'll get it all the way cut off. I like to start a little bit closer to the base than this. Again, this cuts really easily, so be very careful. And next thing is just kind of cut a slit into it like that, okay? And grab some pliers. Sorry, I forgot, told you you needed these. Grab some pliers and just start unpeeling it. If you want, you can give it some heat. It'll make this go a little bit faster, but don't melt it. Just melting it just makes it take a lot longer to come off. I'm sorry, this is wet. This came out of my car, and I've been doing a lot of short trips. you get to that point and it's not coming off, just kind of, you know, work with it a little bit more. Just don't damage the threads. Sorry, not the threads, the barbs. Anyways, I can finish this off later, but I just wanted to show you kind of what you have to do. Just kind of peel it off and work your way all the way back. Once you're done, you basically put the whole kit together, and I'll spare you the time of actually piecing everything together and show you what it should look like in the end. Okay, this is one that I already pieced together here. So you got your 5/16 inch hose. You just kind of cut it like 4 to 5 inches down. Stick the check valve in here. Now the check valve's got an arrow on it. It's pretty easy to tell because this elevated side is going to be away from the evap purge valve line. So you're going to stick it kind of like here. It's got an arrow right there facing that way. So you can kind of see which way the gas should be flowing. Then you're going to run this clamp inside here into this T-fitting with the shorter 5/8 here and the longer 5/8 here. You've got this terminal here, like I told you, that you got off the intake manifold side. You've got the 90 degree elbow right here, the longer hose here, and the terminal over here. And now, assuming you did this in your car, you can basically go back where your intake manifold should be, run the evap line back on it, pop the line back inside, snap this back into place, put the clip back in. On this one, I lost the clip. And over here, on the OEM manifolds, the Dorman manifolds don't have this, so you can just zip tie it to something else. Over here, you basically grab that little washer that came with the kit, put the washer down over that hole over there first, grab the screw, and basically screw this on right over here. Let me grab my screwdriver. And the point of this really is just to make sure that this doesn't go in there, that this doesn't rattle or hit something else, you know, that it's pretty much secure and solid. And so once the kit is together, it should look something like this. And let me back up the camera so you can kind of see a better view of this here. So the nice thing about this kit, again, you don't need to remove this manifold to install that check valve plug, and you just lower it right through there and pop it in. This is pretty easy to work with, but if you absolutely don't want to, you can take off this nylon line right here and replace these sections with a 5/16 hose. That's totally fine. You don't have to use the nylon. I just like using it because it seals really well, and it's I think it's easy to work with, and it's already there. And wraps around over here to this this holder, which is a rubberized hose clamp, and basically replaces this hose. Now again, these are normally, this little section right here that we are cutting apart is normally about $45. So this kit, being about $75 as I'm writing it right now, replaces this whole section and addresses the intake manifold, which is, in my opinion, a really good value. In any case, I hope I touched on just about everything for this kit, just about everything you need to do. A lot more details for any changes that I might have to make in the comments. Go ahead and check the comments. It'll show you where you can buy this kit. And like I said, if you guys have any questions, message me on the forum on the website at cruzekits.com. If you guys need any AMSOIL products, let me know. I'm a dealer for these things, and I sell a ton of it, so I can get you a pretty decent price. And I can get you all of these things that you need in a kit with like an oil change if you want to do that at the same time too. Anyways, thanks for watching, and again, let me know if you have any questions. All right, bye.